Hello, everybody. How are you doing? Welcome to the annual holiday party. We have a lot of good reasons to celebrate this year. We're naming two more streets here on the lab's main site to honor our Nobel Prize winners, Carolyn Bertozzi and John Clauser, both of whom did much of their groundbreaking work here in Berkeley, both on the campus and at the lab. We've navigated through almost a year of COVID surges on and off and develop a new work environment that has brought new opportunities of how we're working, as well as a few challenges that we're still figuring out. We've completed two large complex projects on time and on budget. One was the facility upgrade for NERSC and the other was the facility upgrade for ESNet. And those project teams did a remarkable job delivering those projects through the pandemic, as did all the people around the lab who supported them. We've also had a lot of distinguished visitors, including Secretary Granholm, the Undersecretary for Science and Innovation, Jerry Richmond, and the new Director of the Office of Science, Asmret Berhe. And each one was so impressed by the accomplishments and commitment of the people they heard from here. It was really gratifying. Their strong support of the lab at headquarters and congressional budget discussions has been invaluable to us. And speaking of DOE headquarters, we've received a great set of grades from the DOE Office of Science a year ago, the highest grades they have given to any lab since 2009. And just Wednesday this week, we received this year's grades, and they were every bit as good. So their evaluation of our research and our operations support over these 2 years is as high as any lab has ever gotten. So that reflects on the talent, the commitment, and hard work that all of you have been bringing to the lab. Thank you. As with other organizations across the country, we've also had leadership changes. So we've had a bit of fond farewell to former Deputy Director for Research, Hor Simon, for our CFO, Min Hubner, ALS Director, Steve Kavan, and ALDs, Mary Maxson and Robbie Prosher and Susan Hubbard, Division Directors, David Brown and Mark Asta, and Don Medley, who's headed our government and community relations for so long. But we recently welcomed Bill Collins as the new ALD for Earth and Environmental Sciences, and Stefan Wild as the new Director for the Applied Mathematics and Computational Research Division. And of course, we're running searches to fill those others. And these changes remind us our people have a reputation for addressing challenges that matter. And many of these leaders have gone on to take very impressive new positions in industry, universities, and federal agencies. So fortunately, we continue to recruit very accomplished, committed people into these big roles for us. Our lab community has continued to achieve impressive results in spite of all that has gone on this year, including advancing science and technology to accomplish our energy earthshot goals in hydrogen and carbon removal, geothermal, energy storage. We made progress in other areas too. There was a nice story just a couple of days ago about this discovery by Jennifer Doudna and Jill Banfield about using CRISPR-Cas13 to edit phage genomes. And our researchers' study of the mountainous watershed near the Colorado River is providing critical data needed for managing a water source important to the whole western part of the country. And our scientists who work with the Dark Energy Spectroscopic Instrument, DAISY, have created the largest and most detailed 3D map of the universe to date, and they're not halfway done yet. We're also proud owners of a new user-friendly website, which is an enormous feat accomplished by our strategic communications staff. Examples again and again of what our lab, our people have done here are innovative and immensely talented people. Finally, on a personal note, I want to let you know that I've completed my round of cancer treatments, my radiation treatments yesterday, and everything continues to look good, and I feel great. So I appreciate all of your messages of support and encouragement I get from people as I walk around the site every day. Thanks so much for your concern. And then I want to take the opportunity to say how proud I am to be the lab director here and to thank all of you for making this such a great place to work and make this the best job that anybody could have. We've made enormous progress this year on our science and advancing our culture. And even as we move to this hybrid mode, everybody has been very intentional about maintaining our culture through trust and respect for one another. And, you know, things like the Groove Lounge help with that too. I'm also proud of our staff for its care and concern for the people in our surrounding communities. So this year, we've raised a lot of money for the local food banks. Miles, could you bring that chart up? So there it is. We're doing a great job, and it's been over about $120,000 altogether. And I want to encourage all of you, if you haven't done anything, this would be a good time to do it. Please donate if you can. So we'll put the link in the chat. So this year is something new. We asked for volunteers who would be willing to share their winter celebration and holiday traditions with us through a short video. So we have one that Janie Pinteritz, our Diversity, Equity, and Inclusion Program Manager, did, sharing her family celebration of the new year with an interesting Austrian custom. So I'm going to pass it over to Miles to run that video. Miles.
I was an exchange student to Austria when I was 18, and there I met the person I eventually married. We're a bicultural, bilingual family, and so part of what we do for New Year's is what's called Bleigießen or Zinngießen, and that's pouring of lead or tin as part of a way to divine the coming new year. So you have to go buy the little sets. There's always a spoon, and then there are all these little tokens. These are all symbols of good luck. And one at a time, a person will set one of the tokens onto the spoon over the candle, and you have to hold it here for quite a long time. And when this is all melted, you tip this spoon into the bowl of water really quickly. And then you fish them out of that bowl of water, and then everybody stares at that little piece, and here's one example. And everybody takes a look and turns it around, and everybody gives their sense of what this could mean. So on those backs of those little pieces of paper that come with the tokens, it says, if it looks like a lion, you're going to find friends. And so there's interpretations of all these things here. So, but I would say that this looks like a water fountain with water coming out here. And so I would say that maybe this looks like the fountain of youth. And so maybe that means that I'll have a youthful, healthy year for the following year. And then when New Year strikes, Blue Danube Waltz is played on the radio and TV all around the whole country. And everybody gets up and starts doing the waltz together. And so that's the New Year's tradition in Austria. It's very lovely and wonderful.
Melting things. What a great tradition. Thanks to Janie Pinteritz from the IDEA office for sharing this Austrian tradition with us all. As the lab's deputy director for research, it's my pleasure to introduce the next segment of our year-end celebration. And what has become a fun tradition for the lab, we asked you all to share photos of yourselves, your families, and other family members, most importantly, your pets in festive outfits. And I have to say, you all did not disappoint. We have some very joyous photos to share with you. But first off, we'll start with one of my own. This is Kirby. Let me tell you a little bit about Kirby. Kirby joined our family nearly 11 years ago from what was the Española Animal Shelter in Española, New Mexico. We've had a lot of pound puppies in our family. Being a cross between a cattle dog and a chihuahua, he's a little sensitive about his looks and in particularly his big ears, so he doesn't share my enthusiasm for holiday photos. He did reluctantly agree to participate on this very special occasion. So while I have to say we've never put a full sweater on Kirby, we think he looks very dapper in his scarf. So with that, let's take a look at some of the other Festive and Merry submissions. I have to say, we all know that our pets are part of our family. They kept us sane during the pandemic. And so in their honor, I'm wearing my animal holiday sweater with Baa, and it says Humbug on the back. So with that, let's go ahead and see some of the rest of our submissions of all of our animal friends.
Santa baby, just slip a sable under the tree for me. Been an awful good girl, Santa baby, so hurry down the chimney tonight. Santa baby, a 54 convertible to light blue. I'll wait up for you, dear Santa baby, so hurry down the chimney tonight. Think of all the fun I've missed. Think of all the fellas that I haven't kissed. Next year I could be just as good if you check off my Christmas list. Santa baby, I want a yacht, and really that's not a lot. Been an angel all year, Santa baby, so hurry down the chimney tonight. Santa honey, one little thing I really need, the deed to a platinum mine, Santa baby, so hurry down the chimney tonight. Santa cutie, and fill my stocking with a duplex and checks. Sign your X on the line, Santa cutie, and hurry down the chimney tonight. Come and trim my Christmas tree with some decorations bought at Tiffany. I really do believe in you. Let's see if you believe in me. Santa baby, forgot to mention one little thing, a ring. I don't mean on the phone, Santa baby, so hurry down the chimney tonight. Hurry down the chimney tonight. Hurry tonight.
So thanks everyone for all your photo submissions. Before I hand things over to Michael Brandt, we have one more video featuring holiday traditions from around the world. Our colleagues, Catalina Vega, Sandra Bueno, and Aleja Jurado from the lab directorate will talk about their holiday traditions in Colombia.
I am from Colombia, and for us, we start this holiday season with the Noche de las Velitas, or the Night of the Little Candles, celebrated on December 7th, the eve of the Immaculate Conception. On the night, people place candles or paper lanterns on their streets, on their balconies, parks, sidewalks, everywhere they can be seen. This is a night with a great spirit of feast, where people gather with their families and their friends to celebrate and be thankful for their blessings.
For Christmas, we have two special dishes that we cook and we share with family. They're both desserts. One is called natilla, which we make with milk, cloves, sugar, and cinnamon. It's kind of like a pudding. And the other one is called buñuelos, which is the fried cheese balls. Everywhere you go in Colombia, they will serve you these two dishes.
I want to talk to you about the way Colombians celebrate New Year's Eve. So we have so many little superstitions. So we believe that if we keep like our pockets full of like lanterns, rice, or anything that like brings abundance, then that's the way our year is going to be. We also have like this tradition that we have like 12 grapes, and then we will eat one. And for each grape that we eat, then we will ask like one wish for the next year. So we're full of traditions and we love our family. And that's the way we celebrate our end of the year.
What a wonderful tradition. Thank you, Catalina, Sandra, and Aleja for sharing it with us. And I'd also like to remark, Carol, that is a very festive sweater. Thank you for that. And now it's my pleasure as the lab's Deputy Director for Operations to introduce a recent lab tradition, and that is the reciting of the poem, "Twas the Night Before the Periodic Table." This poem was written in 2019 by Berkeley Lab's own Aliyah Kovner. And it was written to commemorate the 150th anniversary of the periodic table. I must say it's been adapted slightly for this holiday occasion. But this year, Mike Carroll and I wanted to extend the tradition by inviting readers from across the lab to recite the poem. Please welcome Berkeley Lab staff, Aparjita Srinivasan, Harry Caulfield, Jenny Only, Suzanne Budd, Maria Ocon-Lemer, and Rhett Prasad to read "'Twas the Night Before the Periodic Table."
"'Twas a night in St. Petersburg when all through the house not a beaker was stirring and the burners were doused. The acids and bases were cocked up with care, awaiting tomorrow's experiments in pristine glassware. The lab assistants were nestled all snug in their beds while visions of tenured positions danced in their heads.
And wrapped up in blankets offering Baltic winter insulation, Dmitry Ivanovich Mendeleev was beginning a long hibernation. When a spark of historical genius arrived in a dream, a rare human glimpse at nature unseen. With the aha moment, he awoke from his slumbers and scrambled to write down the neat rows and numbers.
See, in this telling, the discovery was quick. In just a few minutes, he made it all click, for his mind had been filled but needed some rest. After 3 long days of puzzling away at his desk, and as the moonlight shone on fresh snow outside, Mendeleev arranged both halogen and halide. Then from his invigorated brain did appear a place for the alkali metals. It was finally clear.
Now lithium, now sodium, now potassium and rubidium, on beryllium, on magnesium, on titanium, and on zirconium, from the hydrogen on top to the lead at the base, Mendeleev devised a system where they all had a place. And when his pattern left a gap in the chart, he didn't despair or tear it apart. The great chemist reasoned these holes simply implied that another element was out there, just not yet classified.
In the years that followed, we added so many more, Berkeley lab found 16, but who's keeping score? And the order and structure saw such constant upheaval that today Mendeleev's first version is bizarre to most people. Yet despite all the flaws in his reverie-fueled revelations, science lovers laud what was built on his work's foundations.
Now we know you're wondering, why rehash this tale? Don't these guys have material that's a little less stale? Well, it's been a hard year and we're feeling the strains. We all want to stop to the pandemic's pains. So we're looking back at the true lesson in its trust. Our brains can do wonders when we give them some rest. During this holiday break, let's take a page from Dimitri and strive for a moment to relax completely. Happy New Year, Berkeley Lab.
I enjoy that so much more when other people are reading it. That's great. Thank you. Thank you. That was great. So let's thank our poem readers for their rendition. And before I turn it over to Miles for our closeout music, I want to say that although this has been a very difficult year in many ways, I appreciate what these past months have taught us about our ability to work together to solve hard problems in research and management and operations. And I personally am very grateful for all of you who make it such a privilege and pleasure to lead this great laboratory. So I'd like to wish all of you a restful and safe holiday. Take some time off and be ready to start and have a very happy new year. So Miles, over to you.
I'll have a blue Christmas without you. I'll be so blue just thinking about you. Decorations oceans of red on a green Christmas tree. Won't be the same, dear, if you're not here with me. And when those blue snowflakes start falling, that's when those blue memories start calling. You'll be doing all right with your Christmas of white, but I have a blue, 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 blue Christmas. Blue, 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 blue Christmas.